Hi, welcome back to the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. I'm Jesus Ramirez. In this video, I'm going to show you 5 Lightroom tips and tricks that you probably don't know. Okay, let's get started. Here I am in Lightroom Classic CC. In this first tip, I'm going to show you how to mask the graduated filter. So I'm going to select the graduated filter by clicking on it. You could also press the M key on the keyboard to select it. And this filter allows you to create a gradient like this one here just by clicking and dragging. And then you can use these sliders to adjust that particular area. So if I wanted to adjust the sky, I could increase clarity, which is contrast in the midtones. Also increase the haze. And by the way, I'm not really worried about making the sky better. I'm just exaggerating the sky so that you can see how it also affects the tower. So I can actually mask the towers out so that they're not affected by the gradient. And the way that you would do that is by clicking on brush and then selecting erase. And when you paint, notice how I'm erasing that effect from the tower. And I can also use the left and right bracket keys on the keyboard to adjust the size of my brush. So I can come in and just paint away these areas so that they're not affected by the graduated filter. So now if I make an extreme adjustment, you can sort of see what I did there. I just basically masked these areas out. Obviously, when you're working on a real project, you want to spend a little more time fine-tuning the mask. In this tip, I'm going to show you how to change the color of anything inside of Lightroom. By the way, I actually have a full-length tutorial on how to do this process, so I'm going to go fairly quickly here. But if you want in-depth instructions, then check out the tutorial. I'll place a link right below in the description. But anyway, to change the color of anything, the first thing that I need to do is select the adjustment brush. So I'm going to click on it. You can also press K on the keyboard. Make sure that all the sliders are set to 0. If you're not, you can just double click on the slider to reset it. Or you can hold the Alt key option on the Mac and click reset, and it will reset all the sliders. So once all the sliders are set to 0, we can start painting over the image. We're going to paint over the area whose color we want to change. In this case, we want to change the color of the saddle to something else. Now, depending on your settings, when you paint, you may or may not see the overlay. If you can't see the overlay, just press the O key on the keyboard. By default, the overlay is red. So if you are painting over something that is red, you really won't be able to tell. So hold Shift and O, and that changes the color of the overlay. So notice how I just painted directly over the saddle and also the horse. To make the painting easier, you can enable the auto mask, which allows you to paint, and Lightroom will select the colors that are similar to the ones that you're painting over. So notice how I'm not going over the lines. You could also uncheck auto mask and hold Control, that's command on the Mac, and click, and you temporarily enable auto mask, and that's actually the way that I prefer to work. And I'm going fairly quickly here. Of course, I'm not working on details. In your image, you may want to spend a little more time working on those details. But for the sake of time, this is going to be good enough for this tutorial. Once you painted the area, you can press O again to disable the overlay and then desaturate that adjustment. So that desaturates that area, and we can now apply a color. And we can apply a color by clicking on this color swatch and just select any color that we want. So if we wanted to make this green, we can select green. And then we can use these tonal adjustments from exposure down to blacks to change how that green is going to look. So we can change the exposure and change how that green looks. And we can even use clarity and dehaze in any of these other sliders so that we can adjust the color. We can always come back, click on the color swatch, and change it to a different color. And obviously, I didn't really work on the details on the edges. What you would need to do is zoom in. So I'm going to zoom in by pressing the Z key and use the left bracket key on the keyboard to get a smaller brush and just paint in those areas. And obviously, I'm not going to spend the time to paint all those details in there, but I think that you get the idea. So this is how you change the color of anything inside of Lightroom. In this trick, I'm going to show you how to apply an auto adjustment to a single slider. So when you're in the develop module, you of course get the development tools. And here under basic, we have this auto button that when you click on it, Lightroom sets all the sliders to where it thinks is the best position for your specific photo. Then you can just fine-tune the adjustments that Lightroom made and make your image look better. But what do you do if you want to work manually and only apply the auto correction to one slider? Let me show you how to do that. I'm going to press Command Z on the Mac to undo, to reset the file back to its original settings. If you want it to work manually and only apply the auto adjustment to a specific slider, what you would need to do is simply hold Shift and double click on a slider. So if I wanted to work manually with the highlights, but then wanted to apply an auto correction to the shadows, I can hold Shift and double click on the shadow slider so that Lightroom puts it in the position where it thinks it best works. And I can do that for all the sliders like blacks, for example, and then adjust the other sliders manually to get a better result. And obviously in this tutorial, I'm not really looking at the aesthetics of the image. I just wanted to show you how the sliders work when you hold Shift and double click on them. In this Lightroom tip, I'm going to show you how to change the identity plate. On the left-hand side of the application frame, you will see the default identity plate, which right now is set to my name, and right above that, Adobe Lightroom Classic CC. But if you go into Edit, you can select Identity Plate Setup, and you can change that. You can change it from Adobe ID to Lightroom Classic CC. Notice how that changes. Now it reads Adobe Photoshop Lightroom Classic CC, and you can also personalize it, and you can put whatever you want. Currently, it has my name, but we can change it to something else. I can change it to ptcvids.com, which is the name of my website. You can also click on this swatch to change the color. So I'm going to select this color here and press OK. You can see that the color changes in the preview window and also on the top left of the application frame. You can also change the font style and font size if you like. Once I press OK, the changes that I've made will be applied to Lightroom. You can also go back into the Edit menu, select Identity Plate, and instead use a graphical identity plate. So you can use a PNG and add your company logo or any other graphic that you like on this area. And for this final Lightroom tip, I'm going to show you how to see the keyboard shortcuts for the module that you're in. Currently, we're in the Develop module. So if you want to see the keyboard shortcuts for this module, you can press Control/. That's the same key as the question mark. That's Command/ on the Mac. And Lightroom displays this overlay with the keyboard shortcuts for this module, Develop Shortcuts. If I go into the Library module, I can hold Control/, and I will see the Library shortcuts. So this is a great shortcut to remember because it'll help you remember all other shortcuts. By the way, I'm curious to know, how many of these tips and tricks are new to you? Let me know down in the comments below. You can simply type in 1, 2, none, all, whatever it is. Also, if you're interested to learn more about Lightroom, then check out my free course on Lightroom CC here on YouTube. Just to be clear, this is a different version of Lightroom than what I used in this video. However, if you learn the principles that I apply in that course, you could always bring them back into Lightroom Classic. I'm going to place a link to it right below in the description. Also, if this is your first time at the Photoshop Training Channel, then don't forget to click on that subscribe and notification buttons. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you again in the next tutorial.